God Thank you. Christmas season progresses, the nights become longer and the days become colder, but tonight in this place we celebrate warmth, we celebrate the light. Countless hours have been spent to bring you light, lots and lots of lights, flickering lights, flashing lights, dancing lights, lights breaking out into the darkness. In fact, tonight you're going to see 60,000 of these lights all choreographed to great music. You know, we are pleased to present you with this light show tonight. And we indeed love these lights, but we love these lights precisely because they remind us of the one true light, the light of Jesus Christ our Lord. And so, my friends, I invite you, sit back, enjoy yourselves, and celebrate the light with us.
Thank you.
a winter wonderland indeed. In city parks and in homes all across this area, there are wonderlands of lights and music and displays set up. Music is in the air. Christmas is such a great time of year, a time to be together, to share the love of Christmas with your friends and your family. What a wonderful feeling. And my friends, what a joy it is to see all of you here together tonight. You know, when Jesus was born, he brought together all sorts of people. Ordinary shepherds from the hillsides, wealthy wise men from eastern lands, and many others. And he still brings people together today. And so what a joy it is tonight. Truly a pleasure to see each and every one of you here tonight celebrating the light together.
Thank you.
Everything that we do seems meaningless. The wrong will fail, and the right will prevail, with peace on earth and goodwill to men. And so if I had the opportunity tonight to walk around this very room and talk to people, I know for a fact that there'd be some of you who would testify about what it's like to walk in darkness and despair. And you, maybe more than anyone else, know the true meaning of Christmas, because you know what it meant when God lifted you up out of the darkness. And we here are also witnesses to that light. That light is none other than the light of Jesus Christ our Lord. We ourselves were once lost, stumbling about in the darkness, but now we're found. We were blind, but now we see. And so, my friends, we celebrate. Yes, we celebrate God's amazing grace.
Now.
Hallelujah. The kingdom of this world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever. Amen. Yet this king, asleep in a lowly animal stable, did not come in the typical royal way, and people then did not fully understand all that his coming meant. The Bible says he looked ordinary. He possessed no splendid looks for us to see. He was born in Bethlehem, which was an ordinary small town, on an ordinary night, much like tonight. But like God always does, he takes ordinary things and makes truly extraordinary things out of them. And so, my friends, what a night it must have been when Christ was born, a most holy night indeed.
to save us now, Jesus.
It sounds unbelievable. Who in this world has believed our report? Yet we know it's true. God came as a baby and dwelt among us. Jesus lived a generous, self-giving life. He healed the sick and he fed the poor. Yet those who saw him laughed at him. He was despised, he was rejected, and on a cross he died. But through it all, he trusted that God his Father would deliver him. And 3 days later did God deliver him, indeed. God raised him from the dead and rescued him. And God will rescue you too if you'll let him. And so, my friends, tonight, are you brokenhearted? Are you lost? Are you stumbling around in the darkness? Will you choose Jesus? He is waiting for you. His arms are wide open. He who is mighty has done a great thing. Yes, he who is mighty has done a great thing. And so, my friends, no matter how you came to this place, it's our prayer that when you leave this place tonight, you'll leave it full of God's peace, truth, and grace.